As part of the Technical Analysis Essentials series, in this video, we are going to discuss what technical analysis really is. We've got a couple of objectives listed in the bottom left of the screen, including understanding price as a psychological construct, presenting price data, and discounting fundamental information, all to help us understand why we actually use technical analysis. So, technical analysis is a way of understanding and analyzing financial markets, which mainly concerns the study of past and present price and volume data in order to form an opinion on the most likely future price direction. Basically, it attempts to predict future price behavior by looking at historic price behavior. And it can extend beyond price and volume data to look at sentiment data and behavioral traits, for example. But the vast majority of TA is based on price. And it's really important to know that technical analysis is probabilistic in nature. No TA methods or system works 100% of the time, and there are no guarantees. But the point of TA is to improve the probability of being right, get that execution about the future direction of price. So, price is the most important thing in technical analysis, and we look at it and analyze through charts. There are a variety of ways we can present price data on a chart. There are the sorts of charts here that we've got on screen that we might look to perform TA on. So on the top left, you've got a bar chart there. On the top right, we've got a Japanese candlestick chart. On the bottom left, you've got a point and figure chart, which is quite an unfamiliar one for most. And the most popular one in the bottom right, you have a simple line chart. You don't really need to know everything about technical analysis to be successful in this area or have effective methods, but most analysts concentrate on just a few methods in which they find work particularly well for them, and usually they have a preferred chart type. We must ask ourselves though, how does technical analysis work? Why does it work? How can you predict price movements just by looking at price without knowing anything about the business or asset you're analyzing? Well, it's important to understand that when you're looking at a chart of price action, you're looking at the product of collective human psychology, which is non-random and has an inherent degree of predictability. And because we are dealing with human emotion and mass psychology, which works in the same way over time, the same patterns can repeat in markets over and over again. Now, to address the question of whether it is necessary to understand the underlying asset, like the business model of a stock or the economics of a currency, you have to understand that all markets discount all information, or most. This is a controversial thing, but we can say at the very minimum, all markets discount most information. That means fundamental information will get factored into the price anyways, but not always in a rational way. Now, we should consider how fundamental information really gets factored into the price. New information can't just get objectively discounted in a formulaic way. Well, here, what actually happens is the information passes through a filter of human biases. Once new information is released, market participants will then form an opinion based on the new information, but their opinion will be heavily influenced by their existing psychology, beliefs, and biases. Then, participants adjust their investments accordingly, which changes the price level to account for the new information. So what's actually being discounted is the collective opinion of information, rather than the information itself. Technical analysis attempts to capture that psychological influence by studying the raw price behavior. Sometimes, how people react to the news is very rational and makes sense, but it can also sometimes be very irrational. When psychological biases and emotion take precedence over logic and reason in the decision-making process, this is the most obvious, though, in many cases, during states of irrational exuberance or bubbles. If we were talking about just casual times where, say, news for a company is bad and the shares move up, or news is good and the shares move down, sometimes markets act irrationally. So TA kind of helps us bridge the gap between that and understand the trend. Technical analysis itself offers a number of advantages compared to other styles of analysis. Generally, TA is uniform across all markets and timeframes. That means the same analysis works on all markets, whether it's stock, currency, bonds, commodities, crypto, etc., and on any time frame, from 5-minute charts to monthly or yearly charts. And also for traders, you can use TA to find precise entry and exit points and price levels. If price moves in the other direction to the one that you're expecting, then you can find precise levels which would invalidate your previous idea and also allow you to exit the idea and redo the analysis. This precision is generally not available from traditional methods such as fundamental analysis. And because of the visual nature of TA, it is very easy to visualize risk on charts too. You can see exactly where your entry, profit targets, and stop losses go, which makes it much easier to manage risk. So to conclude, technical analysis can be extremely valuable, whether you use it just to help manage risk on fundamentally driven ideas, or whether your entire analysis is based on TA. It's a very broad subject, which encompasses a lot of different ideas. You may find some branches of TA very easy to learn and well suited to you, and others more difficult. We'll be covering a very wide range of technical analysis tools and methodologies in these videos, starting with this essential series. So we hope that you will find them useful, and we hope that this video has helped in that journey, and the first of many in our essential series.